I come from Cameroon, but specifically the southwest and northwest regions of Cameroon, where there is already an existing armed conflict between the Anglophones and the government. So the biggest challenge that we are going through now, from the local experience that I'm going through, is that we first of all have the challenge where journalists are not financially viable. Because they are not financially viable, they tend to depend on some politicians from the government and to tend to write sensational reports so that at the end of the day, they can have something to take home in their pockets. And another challenge is that the government, at the wake of the Anglophone crisis in Cameroon, the government has come out with the laws on terrorism. And so journalists are being charged, they are being convicted and condemned, sentenced, not judged by the civil laws that we have in Cameroon, nor the criminal law, but they are being judged from the terrorism law. And as I speak to you now, just last week, a journalist, Mancho BBC, has been given 15-year term jail because he spoke about the Anglophone crisis. And there are many more journalists who have been behind the bars because they are speaking for the Anglophone crisis. So that's a big challenge that we are going through. So because of this, many journalists are afraid to report on the crisis. You know the facts, but you are afraid to say it. So fear comes in because press freedom has been stifled by the government. And so if you don't say anything that is for the government, they come behind you. And if you say something that is relating so much praising the government, then the secessionists also come behind you. So journalists find themselves in a tight corner in Cameroon because of the armed conflict that we are into. With the wake of technology, many people, or what is become known now as the citizen journalist, where people sit within their bedrooms and with the click of a finger, they disseminate their information to a wider audience than where the traditional media can go to. But they don't have the moral responsibility of the impact of their stories, because they don't know the facts. They don't know how their stories can impact the society. They don't care. The videos that they put on social media, they don't care about the harm or the impact that that video can cause to the society. The pictures that they use, the language that they use hate speech. They don't care because they don't even know the impact of that hate speech. And so the greatest challenge is for us now, the traditional media, to be able to counter the information spread on social media, because they are faster. Before you, the traditional journalists, take your time, go to the event, you take your facts, you come to your editorial room, you write a story, you cross-check facts, the citizen journalist has already disseminated the information. And before you come behind, they have already damaged. So we are struggling all the time to repair what social media has done. But it is not completely a bad situation, because I am coming from Cameroon, where many people don't yet have access to the internet, and so they still depend on local media for their information. And so we are still gaining ground. And also we struggle now to create also our Facebook page. We have a WhatsApp group, we have a YouTube, where we can meet the elitist population of our audience, so that when we get the fake news from social media, we tag it to our group, our own page, then we give the verified facts, so that the learned or the opinion leaders or those who can have access to the internet, when they get what they get from the social media, they can verify that from our page. And we are having a lot of followers, a lot of likes, and those who cannot have access to the internet will still meet their objectives because we still use the local medium of radio to the community. I must be very frank that my community radio, the Christian Broadcasting Service Radio, we pride ourselves as the pioneer in Cameroon to handle peace journalism. It is a situation where we make reporters and editors know that they have the responsibility or they have the alternative use of words, that they don't use hate speech, they use sober language. And so we provide a platform where we bring everybody on board. Like the conflicts that we have in Cameroon, we do not talk only to the government officials to hear their own story. We create programs where we bring the government officials and we also bring those who are on the opposite camp. They call them the cessationists, or they call them the antagonized or the marginalized Anglophones. So we try to bring them in a platform. We create programs where people call in. And in that call-in program also, you don't refuse anybody's view. You give your view, and then some other person may also call and counter your view. So that is a platform that we give.